time of sincere service.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. In their affliction, they shall look for me. Come, let's return to the Lord. For it is He who has sent me. But He did us. He has struck us, that He may bind our wounds. He will revive us after 2 days. On the third day, He will raise us up to live in His presence. Let us know. Let us try to know the Lord. As certain as the dawn is His coming, and His judgment shines forth like the light of day. He will come to us like the wind, like spring rain that waters the earth. What can I do with you, Ephraim? What can I do with you, Judah? Your piety is like a morning cloud, like the dew that early passes away. For this reason, I spoke them through the prophets. I slew them by the words of my mouth. For it is love that I desire, not sacrifice, and knowledge of God rather than holocausts. The word of the Lord. It is steadfast love, not sacrifice, that God desires. Help us you and me, O God, in the goodness, in the greatness of your compassion. Wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt. And my sin, cleanse me. For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a holocaust, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn. He bound the God, O Lord, to Zion. By rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem, then shall you be pleased with due sacrifices, burnt offerings and holocausts.
Was beat his breast and say, O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Believe me, this man went home from the temple justified, but the other did not. For everyone who exalts himself shall be humbled, while he who humbles himself shall be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Happened during the Second World War. The prestigious audience, sensing his deep humility, was moved to tears. He gave to God a humble heart, a humble heart. In the words of the seminary professor, what is it we do here? We don't need to tell God what we have done that is good and right. God knows that already. We come to bring God the dearest gift, a humble heart filled with love for God. We present that humble heart in our prayers. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word. If these words begin to steal from our hearts, rather steal from our lips, without rummaging through our hearts to humble them, we can begin again and allow the prayers of the centuries to aim and humble hearts that too often try to puff themselves up. My dear brothers and sisters, indeed, our lips are very near to our hearts, but it seems that it is too far, because most of the time we do it in lip service. It does not go through our hearts. What do we do here? My dear ministers, the four Saturdays of your trainings may seem not enough, but we always rely on the Holy Spirit. The apostles did not have the formal training. If they would take the seminary examinations, I do not know if most of them or all of them would pass. But we rely on the Holy Spirit. And always ask yourselves, whenever you are in the altar, you are privileged, as most of the lay ministers, what do I do here? What is my motivation? Is it for popularity? Is it for my own prestige? Is it for my ego boosting? It is always for the service of the Lord. No matter but it is always motivated because the Lord tells you so. After the Mass, giving 3 to 4 sick people napakainit, and then minsan the sick is not prepared, you may lose your cool. But because the service sa Panginoon, service as translated to the sick, brothers and sisters, you still continue. Now, you may forget what you have learned. You may forget yung mga practical notes and actions, but in the long course of your dedication, of your work, then you will go through it. So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us not be like the Pharisee, experts of the law, knowledgeable of the law. He recognized nothing. He asked for nothing and received nothing. On the other hand, the tax collectors, considered as sinners, recognized that he needed God's gift of righteousness, forgiveness, mercy, and he received it all. Let us now have our commissioning.
As your name was called, please come forward, accompanied by your wife or representative. Cortez of JSC. Austero Hipólito. Mata Napoleon. Ramon Renjo. Saudi Mentor. Pagawisan Charlie. Heredia Lucio. Popiana Danilo, Sena Amir, Del Moro Rodrigo, Edilo Christopher, Zepeda Susano, Delies Romel, Dawang Raul, Jerónimo Rodolfo García Manuel.
Brothers, we are gathered here today to witness the commissioning of the new extraordinary ministers of the Holy Communion
of the Vicary of the Holy Family, Diocese of San Pablo, San Pedro, Laguna. As new members of the ministry, you are asked with a great honor to help the priests, your parish priests, in distributing Holy Communion to the faithful during the Eucharistic celebration, and also in bringing consecrated host to the sick and handicapped. Are you aware of the tremendous demands and responsibilities of this task? In your daily life, are you willing to promote godly virtues and Christ-likeness as evidenced by the fruits of the Holy Spirit within us, which are love, joy, peace, and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control? Are you aware that all these duties and responsibilities are aimed at making Christ known to the faithful, and that we are just his instruments in bringing our families, friends, neighbors, and communities closer to God? Are you willing to foster closer relationship among fellow brother lay ministers within the vicariate of the Holy Family and the Diocese of San Pablo, and also with the members of other lay organizations? As you have professed your awareness and consciously accepted the duties and responsibilities as members of your ministry, I now commission you as extraordinary ministers of the Holy Communion of the Vicariate of the Holy Family, Diocese of San Pablo, here in the city of San Pablo, Laguna. As an indication of your support to our new brothers in the ministry, I now request all lay ministers present here to also come forward and join in the pledge of commitment of the new extraordinary ministers of the Holy Eucharist, Holy Communion.
Lahat po tayo ay mag-pledge of commitment. May I request our line of regular and special meetings, as well as will serve obedience without any reservation to my parish priest and spiritual director as a manifestation of humility and utmost reverence. To the high priest, our Lord Jesus Christ. So help us.
Please stand with contrite and humble hearts. We stand in the presence of God. Let us respond to these intentions with humble and sincere prayer. Let the response be, let your mercy flow to us, O Lord.
Public servants may show special concern for women, children, orphans, the elderly, and the homeless. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your mercy follow us.
The believers may deepen their prayer and penance, especially in the season of Lent. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your mercy follow us.
That the sick may experience the healing power of Christ, and thus give them hope, let us pray to the Lord.
Let your mercy follow us, Lord.
That those who have died may enjoy life, happiness, and peace in heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Let your mercy follow us, Lord. Let us now stop silently praying for personal and communal prayer. Father, you search our hearts and discern our needs. In your mercy, grant what we ask in prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let your sacrifice and mine be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, by whose grace it comes to pass that we may approach your mysteries with minds made pure, grant, we pray, that in reverently handing them on, we may offer you fitting homage through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Rest in thanks to the Lord our God. It is reminding us our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should be the thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us to imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels as with one voice of praise we acclaim. The mystery of faith.
Face, have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed
Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. May we truly revere, O merciful God, these holy gifts by which you ceaselessly nourish us, and may we always partake of them with abundant faith in our heart, through Christ our Lord. Let us now sing the Psalm as Thanksgiving.